way they said that they included the contestants was that it's the top 12 people in the CPT board, 4 people who are the leaders in the regionals, and then 16 extra invites.
Oh, nice.
They just said, you know what, these are the invites. And
yeah,
this is where the controversy comes in.
Okay.
Because once it was announced, a lot of people were like, I'm not happy with who's out inviting.
Do you want to put the list up right now?
Yeah, I'm going to put the list up. So the people who actually qualified via just by being in virtue of being in the top 16. Infiltration, Tokido, Justin, Nakadu, Fudo, Shaohai, GamerB, MLB, Daigo, Julio, Phenom, and Momochi. I don't think anyone's going
to
argue with
There's not too much to question there.
Right. And then, of course, the 4 regional champions were F-Champ,
you clicked on it.
Yeah, F-Champ, Luffy, Bolinho, and Eita. No one's
going to argue with
that. Right. Here we go. So these are the people that were invited. What? CN, Christy Terrian, K-Brad, Ricky Ortiz, Ryan Hart, Pierre Mara, L.I. Joe, some dude named Punk, Snake Eyes, LPM, Wolfcrone, Marn, Smug, Alex Vi, Gutex, and Guilty. Yeah, I know, right? There's still so high in there, right?
Yeah, so I mean, the top half that, like,
I don't think it's that actually that's what you're doing.
Question too much, I feel. It's probably when you get towards the end of that that becomes to become an issue. What are your guys' thoughts?
This guy does not know what he's doing.
Yeah, I'm just
thinking, I like this. I like the list a lot.
Yeah. His best list, because the important part's on
there.
This guy has no idea what he's doing.
Don't say that, bro.
You're supposed to say, what
can
these people
do? Bro, I'm about to say something. It's like, what would I see, like,
because
I haven't, like, seen
Blue
Tech. Oh, my God. Like, last year, Capcom 4 Select, you know, she was watching, and she's good, but I think they invited Blue Tech and Ghosty Wolf because of it.
I'm sure that's good,
but popularity.
Yeah.
And, you know, I mean, and again, like, I look at the list, and I don't really have any qualms about it, because, like, I feel like it's a TV show.
Yeah.
It's a TV show, so they're going to do stuff based on personality as well.
So. Well, and keep in mind, not all these people are on TV, if I'm not mistaken. There's a group stage you have to
right.
get through before it's TV. So, you know, it might be the case that, I don't know, maybe Blue Tech is good. You know, I don't know, I can't get that wrong. The same with Blue Tech, I know he can be good if he comes a lot. I've seen him as good in the past.
This guy has no idea what he's
but
doing.
But there might be a chance that they don't hit. So as far as the choice of it being a TV show, that was my thought originally.
Right.
Like, I get it. You have to be good, obviously. But on top of that, like, if there's, like, a personality or something people want to watch, whatever, then that obviously factors into it because, like, you know, the dollars. Right? But if they're not going to make it to the TV portion,
right, because there's going to be a first group qualification phase, right? So, but my wondering is, are they gonna do like a recap thing? Like, here's a recap of all the stuff that happened, and they'll probably show them if like Marn doesn't make it, they'll probably show them yelling at everybody and stuff, and then show Vutex doing Vutex things and stuff like that, make him do his laugh, you know? Which no one can imitate, like, it's impossible to imitate, right? So, but, maybe not even an hour of recap.
Right.
Who knows? It could even be a 10-minute recap to see somebody. So, but here's the thing, right? If they do make it far past that stage, like, that's a huge benefit for them, right? For the TV show.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And then, obviously, it would be huge for them, you know, for the players, if they could do that, too. I think you told me that if you qualify for these stages, then you make money.
Yeah, that's what I told you.
There you go.
So there's definitely
a reason. Source on this guy.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't know, man.
I saw this guy as well, so we can have more of these.
Yeah,
have you watched the
Counter-Strike
game at all? I haven't played anything else. Yeah, so I
don't really
watch Counter-Strike.
I'm not
into it, but I did watch it once.
Oh, you
did?
Okay.
I don't do that game with you, right? So, I watched it, and it was, like, not cheesy, I would say.
Okay.
It didn't seem like it was, like, esports with ball touch. It didn't seem like, kind of, you know, stereotypical assy esports. Like,
right.
No, it wasn't that kind of nonsense, so. I thought that it was fun. Okay. What do you feel about it being at the same time as
Curly? Well, the only thing I want to add right now is that Curly W is a sexy man. Anyway, continue, go ahead.
Okay, yeah, well, Curly W, speaking of him, he was not too happy either about this.
Really?
Because
in the chat, he just asked me to talk about it.
That's probably what he wants us to talk about.
Okay.
Curly W is a guy who runs brackets for Combo Breaker and I think other stuff. Anyway, tournament organizers were caught off guard. And not just that, but players were caught off guard who weren't like pretty good. Oh, did you find out like the other day? But didn't know.
That's bad.
That's actually really funny, though.
On
top of that, like, teams didn't know, so they didn't know, like, where to send their players necessarily, or, like, maybe they had already made plans for the players, too. You don't have to. Maybe you already had, like, a ticket to go to X or Y tournament.
What about, like, Red Bull Quick, right? It
got invited to both, which is... Yes.
Who got invited to vote?
PR Raw.
Oh,
that's tough, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's even physically
doable. Yeah, like print, right?
Yeah, it's in Paris.
Yes.
To that.
But yeah, it's in the final, so if you can make it to the final, you can still go.
I think that's how it's going to work. Okay. Not everyone's going to be able to do this.
Right.
Okay, fair enough. It's just, it's not just the attendance, though. It's like the stream viewership's going to be different. And
people like the same tournament to watch and stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
It's definitely a possibility. I don't know how big an impact it's going to be, but there's some.
Because even when it was like Red Bull, Kumite, and Combo Breaker on the same weekend. But what is in France, what is in the US, they're not going to overlap each other. So if you want to lock both, you probably could, right? You know. But, you know, in this case, if there's stuff going on for E-League, it's going to be on the same. One time zone over from Combo Breaker, same time zone and a lot of other events. So.
At the same time, look, you can't blame any of the players who go to E-League or anything else.
$100,000 on
the line. Is it only on Friday?
I think it's just Friday.
So, like, Friday could possibly.
Like, it's Friday.
Yeah, Justin has talked about that for Combo Breaker. He was like, please, I'm hoping I'm only in Saturday pools. Like, you know.
Right,
you
gotta run that gamut.
And nice, I mean, like, shout out to Justin who didn't go up to the hot bill and be like, make sure I'm only in Saturday. But just like, please, I hope this happens.
Yeah, but you definitely can't blame any of them for doing you.
That's kind of tiring now.
For sure.
Yeah, at least it's not 34, so. It's not like you travel all the way to the west.
Right.
You're only traveling to what, Chicago.
Do you remember when Luffy went to was it Red Bull Crew there?
No, it was Canada Cup Master Series.
Yes.
That was the weekend that the terrorist attack happened in France. So he got on the airplane and then he got stuck on the airplane for like hours. Because they couldn't take off, and then he finally made it to somewhere else, and then the flight got canceled. They're on the side of like Canada, and then by the time he got there, he literally had like 2 hours of sleep, about 48 hours, and then had to play like seven matches in one day, and he did really well.
The timing of it is unfortunate. I'm very happy for
nice.
People involved. It sounds here. Cool to be on TV. It's nice. I don't think it's like. A major thing, I guess, because I feel like that's meeting time, but it's obviously important. So it's the whole back half of the year.
Being on TV is awesome! It's the great club, I'm stuck!
And you're like, oh, it's cool. Yeah, grandma. Like,
no, I don't
think I'm on there.
For sure. I definitely like that. It's just, I feel like this is the busiest part of the year when it comes to tournaments. Like, these specific times that they've been. The busiest time of the year. If it was, you know, August to September, October even, there are just a couple of events in that like whole period of time. So I feel like that would have been a lesser timing.
Well, I mean, let me ask you, how does it feel to be invited to it? Like, are you excited about this? Are you eager for it?
It's humbling. Like, they get paid, all these players, like,
everywhere, I guess, like in Asia, North America. So it's pretty good. Like,
oh, for real?
Happy, so. Is that humbling or is it deep?
This guy's not actually
any good.
He's got the big head, you know? Kind of thing.
I don't know, but I think it's really cool. It's a great opportunity. I get to be on TV.
Look, Mom!
No, I mean, you're right.
But let me ask, did they say, so is there a prize distribution of the $250,000?
I'm not sure. I don't know anything that you guys don't know.
Okay. Well, I mean, like, do you feel like, let's say you go there, and let's say you win, and you win $100,000.
Do you feel like that's just life changing for you?
I would say $100,000
is like,
yeah,
it's a pretty good.
It's pretty good.
All I'm trying to do here is just make him more nervous, okay? I'm trying to hey, so that's on the line that means. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, no, I mean, like, it sounds like it's a really exciting opportunity to be able to compete for something like that. So.
Yeah, it's worth the great players, though.
It's going to be very interesting to watch more about that. But, I guess that's it about that kind of stuff.
Well, I guess what we can do is talk about the Japan art and thing, but we'll probably take a break really quick before we get to that.
Let's do that, yeah.
And you guys are probably gone after the break.
Yeah, you guys can get to the airport, you got to chaperone him, and then hang out in Los Angeles for the next week. So you're going to be busy as well.
Mm-hmm. So again, no, thank you guys for stopping by.
No problem, man. Thank you guys for having me.
Yeah, no problem.
I want to see you on the show. I had to hang out with James Chan. We ate some.
Did you guys do any cool things?
Yeah, wow. We had some.
We went to a couple of Ichibanya.
Oh, yeah,
so
yeah,
yeah.
We had a lot of conversations.
Alright.
They go with the fan on him.
This is a nice guy.
We had Dave and Joe.
I was watching the IMC of the union. But what we put, I want you, can you just be a jerk? Because I know that that's in there.
How do I do
this? Be a jerk to David.
No, I'm just saying.
Be a jerk to David.
How do I do
this? Let it out on me. It's alright.
That's what we talk about, actually.
Yeah.
Look, like, there are times when you trash talk people, and then when we're on ESL, we're like, alright. What do you think about X or Y? You're just like,
yeah, they're nice. They're nice people. I'm just going to play series with you.
What are you talking about? Alpha male?
Yeah, come on. You can use me as a
sentence. Tell me what you think.
I'm a butt. Tell me.
I don't like his dressing. I don't like how you dress.
Fair enough. All right. You gotta pick something.
Wow, okay.
I need a haircut.
I felt so much anger and frustration from you, Papa. You're like, I don't like the way you dress.
You can become angry sometimes, you know?
Oh, okay.
Alright. Well, so I'll make sure that all the emergency rooms do with my sick friends.
This guy's any good. I don't think this guy's actually any good. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think this guy's actually good.
It's apparently he indicated in a secret meeting that he believed that the bomb threats on Jewish community centers might have been like false flag nonsense. So like that, he started this speech with like good things about Jewish community centers and yada yada.
Sounds like
can you take that seriously?
Yeah.
I just don't know. I doubt it. Yeah, you know what? I'll link in the chat this article.
Oh, yeah. I only got to see as much as you showed me, so I didn't have a chance to see that.
Yeah, you got it.
Shoutouts to whoever just followed. Shoutouts to Paratestes again for the subscription with Twitch Prime. I just wanted to read that out loud because that's the best name ever.
It's a good name.
Yeah, apparently congrats to Infiltration's
getting married.
That's right. Yeah. Infiltration's getting married. But apparently, like, the photo that he showed me, he said it was like something about, like, I get married June, something like that. So, like, I don't know if he meant he's already got married or is he going to get married this June. Because the picture was of someone wedding dress.
Oh. I don't know.
So, I'm not sure.
We definitely saw him in June and July, and nobody talked about that.
Yeah, well,
like,
obviously it wasn't something that he was announcing, you know, talking about
everything. Well, maybe he is, so he's going to do it in June.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, welcome back to Tuesday's show. Like we said, our guest has to battle. And that means we're alone. By the way, I don't think we actually addressed this earlier, but Tasty Tina sitting there on that GDC this week. Mm-hmm. I think we were Breakaway. Commentary for the new game Breakaway. That's good. You know, shout out to them. But as a result, they are not here. So let's move on now to talk about this article that Trouble Blanco put out. I thought it was an interesting topic, you know, point. So I'm gonna paste it in the chat. I know other people have done this as well. And when you YouTube this, can you
YouTube? I'll try to.
Okay. So, essentially, it's about sort of the viability and some thoughts about esports in Japan. And it's not really a thing, right? So, Japan does not have a mature esports market. Is a big part of this, you know, it talks about how their choices have been to sort of help build that, but how it seems like every year people say this is going to be the year of esports, and it just kind of keeps happening. I mean, I think we've all experienced that even in other parts of the world, like in Japan as well, I suppose. And, you know, she identified a big part of that as being that esports or video games, I guess, are not considered to be a profession in Japan. It's not only Japan that feels that way, of course, but that is, you know, a big sort of hindrance to being accepted more, she said. On top of that, you know, only a few gaming-related companies like really market heavily in Japan. When streams happen, when footage happens, it's time. Even people in Japan, they time it so that people in North America can watch. It's like that market is prioritized.
Right. Which even makes sense. Like the Topanga League, you know, they have to have that English stream going, right? And there's a lot of people watching on the English stream as well.
This guy. I gotta be honest.
Yeah,
I mean,
I have definitely fallen asleep to the dulcet tones of her.
Great. Control. Oh. This guy's ranked better than me? I don't think he was actually any good. Oh god, it's one. one of these guys. Oh god. One of these dudes. Why? One of these guys. One of these terrible guys. Why is he so terrible? That's what I thought. How did you wake up Ground Viper? Wow. Wow, that was really incredible. You did wake up. Oh my god. He was mashing Riot Stomp. This guy for real? Does he have dust combos? Alright, he has 8 dust combos. It's not very good. But he's got it. That is bad. Great. This dude is bad. I could have killed him. This dude is like obscenely bad. Oh my god. How is this dude so bad? Huh. Why is this dude so bad, and why am I losing to it? Ground Piper. He's going to Ground Piper. Wow. This dude is obscenely bad. Obscenely bad. Oh my god. Yo, he has a mix-up on his own wake-up. Dude is so bad. How is this guy so bad? How did he know? How does he know everything? This guy has the perfect reaction for everything. Fine. Wow, that worked. Dude, rage quit on me. Nice. Feel this is sad. Oh, this is rad.
For the Red Bull Kumite, SYZZY was announced for the Red Bull Kumite.
Alright, Ultra Chan.
They're not blocked. What are the other two? The other two were, they were both Europe players that were announced.
Oh, yeah, Red Bull Kumite.
No, happy birthday to you too. No, the hosts in the other room left.
Phenom when we talked to him. So of course Phenom, SYZZY, and Luffy has been announced.
Red Bull Luffy. Honestly, that was kind of bad. But yeah,
SYZZY
is very
cool. Yeah, I think it's super
very interesting and strong choice for sure. So Hammer of the Clash, Street Fighter V, won by Don Takeuchi. Second places were Pax Canada and Leo Laura. Fifth places were GSTKR Chun and MD Cringe with Kensley Dawson. Fourth was Takamura, third was AWS Link Exilo with Nakao. Second was RDB. Winner of the
Oh shit, I'm dead. Stream, please.